Welcome back to the videos, Late Late Fam. Today we have some GTI content for all of you viewers out there. With today's video, we will be doing some modifications on the GTI as all of you guys have been requesting since day one. And the reason why I can't always modify this car is because we just bought this car to be a fun daily for my dad. And I don't want to modify the car to increase breakages or to increase breakage cost, if it makes sense like that. So today we're just going to do some few modifications to the car which will lead this car to be a great daily. So today what I will be changing on this car is that I will be changing the number plates, because I know many of you guys are really fond of these number plates, and I'm very fond of these number plates. I will be changing the fog light lamps as well, because the driver side fog light lamp actually cracked, and it cracked because of the heat distribution from the bulb itself, and the bulb actually burst, and that's the reason why you guys can see like this dirt on the inside, or this degree on the inside. So what I will be doing is that I will be changing out the lamps, because I bought a brand new set at Racing Edge. So if any of you guys looking for Golf 5 spotlight lamps, you will be able to get it at Racing Edge. They don't sell the entire cover, but they do sell the lamp itself. And I bought me the spotlight as well, so I will be changing the spotlight to crease. I will be changing number plate lights, and I will be changing the number plate lights at the back as well, because at the back there's only one holder for some reason. We bought the car like this, as you guys can see right here. There's no holder right here, but there's a holder right there. So I bought these license plate lamps for the Golf 5, 6 and 7, so it will fit in the Golf 5, 6 and 7. So it's an entire like holder you can just clip in right here, because we have one holder missing. And as you guys can see, this holder right here is actually very loose. I will be trying my best to actually get like both holders flush. Many of you guys who own the Mark 5 to Mark 7 series Volkswagens, many of you guys know whenever you're putting LEDs in your number plate light, it shows your error on the dashboard to show like the number plate bulb is actually dead. But it's because you're running an aftermarket LED bulb, if I can say it like that, because it usually picks up as an error. So these ones I bought at Racing Edge apparently don't give you any errors on your dashboard, so I will be trying that out as well. And if it actually works, it's actually a very great buy, to be honest. And it's a full holder, so I will take you guys through all these mods I have right here. This is actually how the holders actually look. And I mean, like, if you think about it this way, you just plug it in and it's supposed to work, I guess. Yeah, so you just plug it in right here and it should work. So apparently this like bypasses the error coding on the dashboard to show like it's almost like original lights in the car. So I'll definitely recommend this if it actually takes that error light away on the dashboard, because at the moment we actually have an error light on the dashboard, but that's because one of the number plate lights aren't connected, because we only have one holder. And I really hope that it will bypass the error code for the spotlights as well, because at the moment we have an error code for the driver side spotlight, because like I said, one of the bulbs actually blew up. And we will be replacing these normal lenses with these aftermarket lenses, which actually look way better than these standard lenses, because you guys can see there's like this like bulb holder on the inside, which the headlights actually has as well. But these ones, or these ones in the car, don't actually have this like insert, if I can state it that way. So we will be definitely changing this up, and I'm 100% sure that the light will actually shine very bright on the road, because I know Smiley has the same crease in his spotlights, and trust me, Smiley only drives with his spotlights and not with his headlights. So his spotlights actually shines way brighter than his headlights, and that's why I'm actually very interested in these crease, because you have to buy a very specific crease. I'm not sure what ones these are, It doesn't state here. Maybe it states on here as well. I'm not sure if that will help any of you guys to buy a spotlight, if you guys want to buy a spotlight for your GTI, but I really hope this helps. I actually wanted to change the headlights for this car as well, but the headlights are quite expensive for this car, because you guys can actually see right here that it's not in a very, very good condition. And I like the front end of the car to actually look very, very new. So I think I might just give it another polish in today's video. But we will start off straight away with the spotlights, and from the spotlights we can move on to the number plate lights, and from the we can move on to the number plates. So I will be putting you guys on a time lapse while I'll be removing the spotlights of the car, the spotlight lamps, and I will do a comparison with the old ones, comparing them to the new ones. Just to briefly explain how to remove these spotlight lamps out of your Mark 5, here's one screw right here which makes you remove this cover, which goes in right there and goes in right there. Then you just unscrew that and you clip this entire cover off. Then you have three screws right here which the spotlight lamp actually mounts into the bumper, and from there this is like a normal clip which you unclip the spotlight itself, or the spotlight bulb itself, and then you get this one removed. Here we have a comparison between the old lamps and the new ones, and you guys can see that difference like immediately, and to be honest it's way better looking in my opinion. Like all the like the inside, like you guys can see the inside of this one, it looks very, very similar to the headlight. So I would definitely prefer these ones above these ones, although these ones are actually, well, original. So I'll definitely prefer these ones, but just keep in mind this one actually drove like 200,000 kilometers, and that's why it looks like this. So definitely buy yourself a set of new spotlight lamps whenever you're gonna replace it. Don't clean it up, just one time buy yourself a brand new set, and trust me, it's worth the cash. I'm just quickly gonna transfer the bulb to the new spotlight, so I will be inserting the Cree, well, spotlights, which is laying right here, into the new spotlights. Then I'll briefly explain to you guys afterwards how I achieve that, because it doesn't look too difficult, but I'm just gonna figure it out myself real quick, and then I'll briefly explain to you guys how I did that. Just another quick comparison, as you guys can see, I told you guys that one of the bulbs actually blew up, and here you guys can see this is how the bulb looked in the cracked fog light lamp, and here you guys can see how the light or the bulb is supposed to look like. So well, a before and after, but now I will be replacing these ones with these Cree LED spotlight bulbs. So it's very, very basic, and then all you do, you just clip it in and you rotate it to whatever side you need to clip it in. I didn't like go that far here to check what side you need to slide it in. So it actually shows here, so you have to turn it to the left to actually open it up, and if you turn it to the right to close it. Very, very basic. All the instructions are on here. I didn't even see that myself. When you're done installing the LED Cree, this is how it's supposed to look. So all you do, you just line up all three clips, and then you just turn it to the right to actually clip it in. So from here, I'm actually going to start installing the spotlights real quick on another time lapse. Then we can actually test it out, because I know that one of the spotlights didn't work. So now we'll be able to drive with the spotlights and will look very, very similar to the headlights. Just keep in mind the original headlights in the car, it's still normal. I'm not sure what specific headlight is in here, but I definitely want to change up the headlights to crease as well in the future. So let's get to installing these spotlights. In my personal opinion, these spotlights actually makes a big difference on like the front end of the car, because those older ones looked like disgusting, and obviously because one of them were cracked, but even before it was cracked, it still looked disgusting. So let's put the spotlights to the test to actually see how it looks during daylight, because I like driving with the spotlights on during daylight and even at night as well. So let's put it to the test. We won't be able to see how it actually shines on the road because it is daylight, and obviously we can't go out during the night because of the lockdown. So let's just give it a test and put the lights on real quick to see how it looks during the daylight. Opinion, this looks way neater than the old spotlights, and to be honest, I don't think they will be shining very, very bright on the road, because as you guys can actually see the reflection on the wall, but you can't see that much. So I was probably guessing this was probably just for show, and that's the only reason why I installed them as well, because the spotlights wasn't working. And I mean, like, if something is there and there's no use for it, then you just remove it. So I just one time replaced it, bought new spotlight lamps, LED crease for the spotlights as well. And obviously I still need to change these sparks as well, the LED, to make the entire front end LED. But damn, I personally like this look. But enough of this, let's move on to the number plate lights real quick. One thing I want to show you guys about the number plate lights, as you guys can actually see, only one is on and here's nothing. So at night, if you look at the number plate, there will only be a light shining in this area right here. And I personally didn't like that at all, because how does it even look? Yeah, I've got 5 GTI, but you can't even afford the number plate lights. But the thing is, we didn't have this entire like unit here, so that's why I bought these units right here. And hopefully they will just plug in and go on. So I'm gonna put that on a time lapse real quick as well. I think these ones only plug in, I'm not sure about these ones. I think they clip out as well, so I'm just gonna check that real quick. And then after I get these installed, then we can actually start moving onwards to pasting the new numbers. Just be careful when removing these number plates, because you guys can actually see this one was actually really broken for some reason. So someone really like attempt like petering with this. So I would definitely recommend buying the new ones, because these look very, very fragile. Same principle supply as the spotlights, plug and play, very, very easy. And then yeah, let's move forward. Looking around for the second plug, I actually found out that this one was hanging inside of the bumper the entire time. So this is how it's supposed to look right here, and you guys can see the other ones actually cracked. So we actually have both here, and that's why it never gave us, this bulb was probably blown. That's why it gave us the error on the dashboard. But we're gonna fit the new ones anyway, because these ones are the normal bulbs and the aftermarket ones are obviously the LEDs. So I'm gonna start fitting the LEDs real quick. For some reason on camera is actually doing that, but like in person it's not like going like on and off the whole time like that. I don't know if you guys can see it from a further distance, you guys can see it's actually still on, but it still does that kind of effect for some reason on camera. But now we got both number plate lights installed, we can actually start moving forward to getting those new plates on the car. Thank you. So what I did this far is that I got this entire piece removed. I got all the sticky glue off this piece right here, but I'm thinking I'm just gonna remove this piece one time and place the number plate just on this area right here. But what I'm gonna do right now is that when we first bought the car, this piece was actually cracked right here. So I actually bought a little bit of Q-bond. So we'll just be Q-bonding this piece into this area right here. And then from there, I'm just gonna tape off this entire piece right here. Tape off this entire piece right here. And actually just use plastic dip just to cover up this piece for now, to make it look a little bit more neater than what it actually is for the time being. So I'll do all that on a time lapse real quick, then I'll give you guys a update as soon as I'm done. Personally, this is probably the best mod I've actually done on this GTR. So the only thing I did is I just used a little bit of Q-bond. Q-bond is a very, very strong glue with, I don't know what sure, like it's like a powder. You throw over it and you use the Q-bond, and then it like really like strengthens up this entire plastic piece right here. I glued it on the inside of this piece right here, as well as on the inside of this piece right here. So you guys can actually still see that crack, but it looks way, way neater, and I'm really impressed with the Rust-Oleum plastic dip product, because it's a really amazing off finish. And just keep in mind, on a future video, I will be doing this plastic dip on the GTI's wheels, so stay tuned for that video. But thus far, I'm totally stoned with the results, and you can't see that broken piece like from a far distance. So all I need to do before this car is done, just place the plate and wet the wheels. Just finished the GTI just in time, because my dad was planning on taking the car to work today. So I just finished the GTI, got everything done. I hope the cinematics actually does justice, because I mean, like, in person it looks way better than on camera, I'm not gonna lie. And I felt like these few touches that car definitely needed, and I literally bought all this at Racing Edge, except the number plates. Just keep in mind the number plates, I don't think the number plates are fully legal, and I know many of you guys have been asking for the number plates, but unfortunately my supplier prefers to remain unknown due to, because it might be illegal. But it does have the SA stamp on, if you guys can check right here. It has the stamp on right here, and it has the same plates like the Conquest. So, well, it definitely changes the car completely, and I hope you guys can leave a thumbs up for this video. And just remember guys, like, during lockdown I'm trying my utmost best to provide you guys with some content. So these videos in this 21, this one is actually be me driving around, and I can't leave my house. As you guys can see, I can definitely move the cars around and stuff like that, but I can't leave my house and walk down the street to anyone or something like that. So everything that will be happening in either that garage or this garage, But I'm definitely gonna respray the GTS wheels for some plastic dip. The plastic dip I actually used for today's video was this Rust-Oleum. I bought it at Midas. I think I paid 170 for it. And I bought some other stuff as well. So I bought like entire packet of stuff. So I bought another Rust-Oleum for the calipers, but I'm gonna use that for the valve cover. I bought some T28. I bought some polish. I bought some sanding paper. I bought some metal filler for the curb press for the GTI. I bought terminals because I know the Conquest doesn't have any terminals on for the speakers. I bought sealant just in case for the valve covers. I'm gonna try to respray the valve cover of the Conquest as well as of the Caddy. I'm gonna clean both engine bays because I bought some degreaser as well. And I bought a service kit for the GTI, so the GTI will definitely get a service. I'm not sure when because my daddy is using like the cars in this time period because he has to go to work. Because he works at Pick n Pay and he's like, it's compulsory for him to go work. So the Caddy is here today and obviously the Conquest, but I'll try my utmost best to provide you guys with some content. I'm going to try to get the Touring Cam wheels sprayed better in the meantime, but I don't have any spray for that, to be honest. So I'm just glad that everything is done on the GTI right now. But guys, just remember to be safe. Don't be any of those idiots out there walking on the streets because you guys are risking the human race, if I can state it that way, because you guys have to stay off the road. You guys can see how empty it is right here. There's a few people at the bottom of the street, but that they're at the house. So stay off the streets, don't drive, because apparently they're locking up the people if you don't have a permit on you or like a pass to drive on the road. Like my daddy had to take the pass out of the Caddy and into the GTS, so whenever they pull him over, he has a pass to show that he has to go to work. When without that pass, they will lock him up. So just be careful out there and don't go to the shop unnecessary and things like that, and always sanitize, wear mask, wear gloves. Me at the moment, I'm alone, so I feel kind of safe in my area, but don't let your friends come over. Just be safe on your own bus. Keep yourself busy, and that's the reason why I bought all these materials and stuff, to keep myself busy with all my cars. And unfortunately, you guys won't be seeing any of my friends anytime soon because I'll have to work on all these cars alone. And that's kind of hard to do. All of you guys are going to be missing your friends, but just stay strong. And just keep in mind, guys, if you guys are not going to follow the rules of the government or Cyril, what's going to happen is that they're most probably going to extend the 21 days. And that's exactly what we don't want, because the virus is actually worse in our country as the beginning stages in other countries. So let's stop this virus. Let's start listening to Cyril, start listening to the government, and follow every rule that has been given out from the government, and just be safe out there. But remember, guys, leave a like, subscribe, and follow along with more related content. And please remember, you can't in this time race all ghost stunts. You can maybe lower your car at home, but stop racing and ghost stunts. One thing I forgot to mention is that although one of these spotlights are actually cracked, they can still be of use for anyone. So if anyone wants to buy them, I don't have a price on these, so just hit me up with an offer. And then you guys can most probably take these spotlights off my hands. Unfortunately, I don't have any other covers for them, but anyone's interested, hit me up on Instagram. Or just comment down below a number or Instagram and I can send you a message.